Okay, welcome to Advent of Code. Today we are solving backlog of tasks. We already solved today's tasks, so we have 5 tasks to finish 2018, and then maybe we'll start looking at previous years. This one we didn't solve, right? Yeah, it has a star, but we didn't solve it. Are they using like glow effect? Yeah, text shadow. That's nice. Today was pattern magic on whole lines. There are only 9 possible words. Yeah, that was. I had this idea as well. I also think they could have made it so that like you don't know what X, Y, and Z means, but like which one. So you try all the combinations and see which one gives you best score, or even better, like worst score, but you still win more cases than lose, like something like this. That would be probably interesting, but it's also like you just go through all the variations. There's no algorithmic complexity in there. Anyways, let's prepare first real quick. Create all the necessary files so we don't spend time on that. We want this template, template is okay. XX is, which day is this? 21. I get 21, and the year is 2018. Okay, day 21. We go right here. Okay, so we have our setup. Somewhat right, we don't need this. Should we make font bigger? I wonder, like 15 or something. Is it better? It's probably better, right? I probably want some extra space for lines. Like this. Yeah, okay, cool. I should make it into profile actually, but yeah, it's too late for that now. Okay, let's see. Yeah, let's see. Let's I need this fixed as well. It works. Let's read the task. Chronal conversion. Hopefully there is nice visualization in here somewhere, but yeah. You should have been watching where you've been going because you wander to the North Pole base, you trip and fall into a very deep hole. Just kidding, you're falling through the time again. If you keep up your current pace, you should have resolved all of the temporal anomalies by the next time the device activates. I have no idea what this story is about, actually. First, discover that time device is hardwired to always send you back in time in 500-year increments. Changing this is probably not feasible. Second, discover that activation system your model input for the time travel model currently appears to run forever without halting. Oh, halting problem. Nice. I've heard it's you need about an hour to solve it. if you can cause the activation system to halt at a specific moment, maybe you can make the device send you so far back in time that you cause an integer underflow in time itself. Nice. And wrap around back at just 2,000 years, right? So not that long ago. Integer underflow. Okay. The device executes the program as specified in manual section 1 and manual section 2. Your goal is to figure out what? This is something from day 16, and I have no idea what happened on day 16. Oh, fuck. Oh, no. Okay, this was gonna be painful because I have no recollection. Apparently, I do have interpreter for it, right? So that's good, I guess. Okay. Let's see. Your goal is to figure out how the program works and cause it to halt. You can only control register 0. Every register begins at 0 as usual. Because time travel is a dangerous activity, the activation system begins with a few instructions which verify that bitwise end, where Bunny does a numeric operation and not an operation as if the inputs were interpreted as strings. If the test fails, it enters an infinite loop rerunning the test instead of allowing the program to use normally. If the test passes, the program continues and assumes that all other bitwise operations also interpret the input as numbers clearly also. Was the system rewarded that someone might introduce a bug while trying to emulate the system with a scripting language? What is the lowest negative integer value for H0 that causes the program to halt after executing the fewest instructions? The same instruction multiple times causes multiple instructions. Okay. We have our input. I'm not sure what IP1 means. Okay, I guess we have to check this first, right? Yeah. Let's see if there is something about this IP. No, but where is input? Yeah, there is a very different input. Maybe. Okay, let's see. So, stores, interaction, blah, blah, blah. Okay, let's try to see like SETI, right? SETI. Come on. Set immediate stores value A into register C, input B is ignored. A into register C. So we store this into fifth. How many registers are there? 16 registers, right? Okay, probably. So, okay, we're trying to like to check this program. So we put 1, 2, 3 to register 5, B, any bitwise and immediate stores into register C, the result of the bitwise F, A, and B. So stores into register C, the result of bitwise and of register A. And so we basically bitwise and 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6. Okay. AQRI equal register. Okay, so check that the value is probably 72, right? DDR, A DDR. Stores into register of increase A to register. B, and we control which register? We control register 0. This is ignored, right? Okay, so yeah, as I said, okay, what happens is in other add register stores and register still have one register A and B. So basically 5 plus 1 storing 1, right? And then we store 0. Like what? Why would we need this? This is probably does nothing. And this probably does nothing. So this is about register 1. This stores 0 in register 5, and then we compare OR with this into register 4. Then we set E into register 5, register 3. Right, then we store 5 and register 5 and the bunny. Okay, where is EQRI? Let's see what says register C2 1 if register A is equal to B, otherwise set register C2 0. Wait. Yeah, there's addition to rows, okay. So probably this one is like looping or something. Yeah, so this is IP1. Yeah, okay, so this is what it is. So IP1 means register 1 is going to be jump register, right? And ADDR basically does what? So we add 5 and 1 and store it in 1. Okay, so EQRI. So register 5. If register A is equal to value B, it stores 1. So basically, it stores 1 into 5. And now we take current pointer and add 1 or the loop, right? So, or we jump. Wait, how does it work? Set 0, 0, 1. Wait, what? Which is 5 registers. Okay, so basically this says if we add 0, we go to here and this jumps you back here. But if we have 1, we jump this over and this is basically infinite loop. Okay, so this is check. Okay, nice. So now we write this is doesn't matter as far as I know. Just yes. Okay, so we set 0 to 5, we do OR with this, we set, store it in 4, we do this, we AND, and then we do other 3, 5, 5. So basically we add register 5. Oh, 5 is normal, it's not jump. Okay, yeah, whatever. 5, where is adder 3, 1, 1. So this are probably the jumps, right? Set E27, 1. Uh, and we can control register 0. But there is nothing happens about register 0, or am I missing something? This is the only one that works with register 0. Okay. So this we can eliminate, it doesn't matter, right? This I don't know. maybe we should run some visualization or something and see what happens. As far as I remember from solving this, the way to solve this is to run it, see what happens, and then analyze it with your head and figure out the answer. Like, you can't emulate, like, it wouldn't work. Okay. Day 19 we need as well. Okay, let's start by requiring this and see if it works. No. Wait, what? Yeah, because it's now called just closure mask. Okay, this works, right? We also have our input, which is day 21. We probably don't need the IP part. Day 21. We need parse. So if I do day 19 parse. No. Like this, right? Sample, yeah, we don't care about sample. What? We should resolve this, like, what? Like, EQ, like this works? No, it doesn't. Why? I guess. okay. I don't get it. The symbol works, yes. Why doesn't... Resolve. How do you resolve... Probably need... look and closure. Okay, so we have an sResolve which requires namespace. How do I get a namespace? Oh, probably, like, what if day 19 was it? So this only works for current namespace, right? How do I get namespace? Their name, like what? Zen apes. Okay, this is first for me. Okay, but first let's see if this works. Okay. But like this, what? No, this also doesn't work. What? But it's right here. Why it's not working? Okay, this is something from closure that even I don't understand. EQ, because it's called EQRR like this. Okay. Okay, now it works. Now it doesn't. Okay. But yeah. Let's update this with why it's as complicated as it is, but no conversion to symbol. What do you mean no conversion to symbol? What? Oh, maybe this should be like zero or something. Yeah, cool. Okay, so we have this. Which is our program, right? Let's double check that. Let's set ignores its second argument, right? Input B is ignored. Input B is ignored. Maybe I should put minus one here or something. Yeah, but maybe I can just teach it to ignore. Because what happens if we do parse along this? Yeah, okay. This works fine. Okay, yeah. We have some nils, but that's okay. Ignored. So basically set R and set I. We have set R, this is ignored as well. Okay. This is just for to read so it reads more easily. The only reason. Okay, so we have this, right? This is our program. We can try to run it actually. And the way it works, max steps and registers opens and register recurring. So we need something like this, right? Let's call it run, actually. Run. Program IP breaks max steps. Like this, right? Run and let's do command run data one 0000. We have six registers, right? 1 0 to 5. And let's say 1000 steps. Okay, cool. So this is our program, right? Let's see. We also need probably some program pointer of index. So basically, we need also, we need print here actually. Right. But yeah, we can actually interpret step and like, watch it in second register. But where's fun in that? And it's actually let's copy this and let's analyze it. And we probably want our program on the left. Yeah, we don't need. Like this, and we probably want also op index, right? We want increment this so it matches let's I'll actually run it again. Okay. What I'm after. We want this, and we don't want this. Okay, so now position. Yeah, we don't need step. But yeah, let's. It doesn't matter. So this matches our program counter, and what we see here is we got 19, 20, 21, 23, 25, 23, 24. We jump over 24, we jump to 25, right? Then we go 26 and go back to 17, 18, 19, right? And we jump to 26, 26, 26, 26, 26, 26, 26, 26, 26, and that's our loop. Basically. So basically our loop starts on line 19 here. Do any of the registers and it ends at 26. Right, and nowhere in here do we access the register 0. What the fuck? Print out hi, hi, Alexander. Do values in here change actually? They do, right? So, yeah, they do change. So, basically, the register 4. Is incrementing, so it's slowly like 24 85 85, boom 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 boom. So it grows slowly like register 4, so basically it would be index 3. Yeah, basically this is why it grows by 1. So let's do R3 plus equals 1, right? This basically means go to 19. Like we go here, we actually go like to 17, which is 18 line plus 1, where we go here. Here what we do is add e r2 equals r3 plus 1, r2 multiply by 256, get rr. Get RR greater than register, okay. See if register A is B, if R2 equals 1, like this, right? Maybe I should write a program that like rewrites it in this style. Maybe it would be easier to read actually. And then we'll just have to like modify C program. Add DR. I think it adds to register A and register B. R1 equals R2 plus R1. And R1 is, we know, it's go to basically. Yes. It's basically go to. Go to plus R2, which is. So basically, either go here or here, right? So this defines, and R2 is this, which is zero most of the time. So this is add one to this. This is multiply, and then we compare it with R4, which is 6, 5, 5, 3, 6, right? So this is gonna be bigger than so this has to reach 256. So let's run it for 2000 steps actually. Let's see where it leads us. I need to wait a way to clear this output section. Okay. Somewhere around here. Yeah. So there's 24, 25. This gets like 6, 5, 5, 3, 6, right? Uh-huh. And we get to 27, 28, like here. This is basically go to 7 or 8 or 9, go to 9 actually, right? Yes, and this is we go like 28. I'm still not sure how are we supposed to get here. But this somehow drops this value to 256, right? And it starts all over again. Oh no, it actually drops this to 1. And then it goes to 30. No. And then it goes high again. Because it takes value from here to here. And then this starts to grow like slowly again, right? But this time we have this huge value here. And there was something about underflow, actually. Yeah, I know what integer underflow is, but how are we supposed to get like negative integer? Is this like 32 bits or something? No, 64 maybe? No. So basically, this is what we have to do. We have to figure out what this program is doing, right? We have to figure out how we can get to this position. And if register 5 is equal register 0, which we control, is the only one we control, right? At the very end. We write this to 3 and address of 1. And basically, we either go away, so it has to be equal, so we jump over this one. This is go to back to 5, right? Go to 5, well, actually 7, but okay. Okay. So, basically what our task is to figure out what this program does, how long does it do it. So it's not halting problem at all. We just need to like decode this, decipher this program. What does it do? And where does integer underflow happens? Oh, halt means stop, right? So we need to figure when it stops. Yes, so it's okay. Okay. I probably want to. I still don't understand what's like integer underflow. But Yeah, I probably want to decipher this program somehow. I wonder what this does, like register 5 basically, right? So it does something. Oh, whatever. Let's comment this, right? So this is like our checks. We don't care about them, right? I probably want... Okay, so this means R5 equals 0. Let's do this. This means R4 equals R5 65536, right? Wait. This is very boring. It's like just has one bit set, right? So this basically means set one bit. R5 equals this strange number. Is it interesting somehow? No, it doesn't seem so. R3 equals R4 and 255. 255 is interesting, right? It's because lowest 8 bits, yeah. No 0 0 1 1 1 1 1 1 1, like this. Okay, and this is 0 B. One, two, three, four. Okay, 1, like this, right? This is, I don't know. R5 equals, that's basically plus equal R3. R5 and equals this, which is, oh, I see, actually it's, yeah, okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so basically 6 ones. Didn't know that. R5 multiplied by this. R5 equals again the same number, right? Maybe there is some way to like, is maybe we can run this program actually. That's what I'm thinking. But do we support comments? I wonder. Do we support comments, right? Very much as. Maybe star. Like this, right? This way we can read the program, right? Can we? Okay, so now what we do is we actually comment this out, right? Because we just need to know what value of register 5 would be. Basically run data one. Okay, let's say we want to run for million operations, right? Did I remove? No. I didn't remove print. I never done that print. Okay, so this didn't work. Okay, let's see what the data is. So it is 701. Yes. So now we support comments. We have run and remove print. Okay. So it actually step. Wait, what? No, I didn't step. This is wrong. Why? It actually did reach the end. Wow. It did reach the end. In just 2000 operations, so it's trivial actually. Okay, so we need to register 5, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is our value basically. 3, 1, 1, 5, 8, 0, 6, right? So now if we put this in here, if we uncomment this, okay, we stop. At step 1848. I'm not sure if it's the lowest. Oh, no, it's lowest. Okay, so yeah, I made it harder than it has to be. You just need to run program, you don't need to understand it. Okay, yeah, that's fine. But this is because, like, last time I saw this, you couldn't run this program. I remember that the computation was so slow. It's basically like four nested for loops, each one incrementing by one, and then like when this one is done, like the next one starts incrementing, and it would take like billions, trillions of operations, and you just need to like parse it by hand. Actually, you can't do it programmatically. But okay, yeah, that works, sure. It's easier than I thought. In order to determine the time window for end of flow exploit, you also need the upper bound. What is the lowest non-negative integer value for register 0 that causes program to halt after executing the most instructions? Fuck. Okay. The most instructions. How do we know that it executes the most instructions? So now we need to understand this. So this basically says R3 equals R5, R0, right? And this is basically means go to R3. Otherwise, go to 7. Otherwise, we go here, right? Well, you know what? If op index equals 28, right? So if we're about to execute this comparison, okay, let's run it for a million time. Okay. So if we run it for a million times, this is what we get, right? With all of those, program will halt. Like at some point it starts to grow or what? Oh, wait, we need floors, right? No. Wait, what? No, I need... What is the lowest non-negative integer value? So we need to execute as many instructions as possible and then halt. So basically we need like the biggest value of this. That was last, right? Maybe we do need to analyze the program. Maybe not. Let's try this one. Actually. So this was 3 million, right? That's not so much, that's too high. Okay. Wait, what? I also had the suspicion that we're dealing with overflow. How could this answer be too high if I can like if I use this number, right, as a register 0, how many instructions do we get? We get a lot, right? But I have suspicions that we are running it wrong, like with overflow and stuff. Maybe. Maybe not. Like I get this many instructions, right? So I can use this number to get this many instructions. And you're saying there's a lower number that can get you more instructions. Number get you more instructions. Maybe we do need to run first instead of last. This is too low. I'm looking for something. I'm understanding this wrong, I feel like. So basically, yeah, probably the problem is like if we already seen it, right? We shouldn't. Certain mob sorts keys, right? We have something like priority map, right? Basically, what priority map does. Number and then step, right? And the first will be the smallest step. And we need the most instructions, right? So we need the last probably. That's tricky. This is wrong step actually. Yeah? Like key value, and we sort by value. The biggest value is most steps, but the value is already there. It's fewer steps. Okay, yeah, this is probably what we're looking for. And what we look for is that this stops changing. It doesn't seem to stop changing. So maybe we do need to analyze program after all. With all its like bit operations and stuff. Like if we pause here, see. doesn't seem to stop at all. Nope, it's not going anywhere. Fuck. See it right here. Maybe there's a pattern. Maybe we should print pattern of binary representation because it's like binary operations. I think there is, yeah, along the string. Okay, so what if we last R5s let R5s last R5s oh good step is like R5 long to string R5 to. How about this? And to prove they want it. I don't know. Slash T here and slash T here. What? What? So, any patterns? That's really right. Oh yes, works like this. But still, not really any pattern, right? How long is this? Let's send 0. Link this, right? No. Remember, like, format. Yeah, just present it to us. Should work. Right. Yeah, kind of. Not sure I see any patterns, but don't see any patterns. Like everything is something, so like there is this cluster of ones. I don't think it means anything. What if it's just like on once like this, and it's 24? So like, and that's not the answer as well. Wow. Like the just execute program. Maybe I understand drawing, like what is the lowest? Like what goes first, like most instructions or lowest negative integers? Lowest that causes the heart. We know it, right? So they are executing program. So I must be doing something wrong. Wait, what? So yeah, this is like supposed to be a set. This number never ends. Like at some point, this program should Not halt. What? Like here we see advice, print advice. Start with print advice. So how are people making it harder than it is? You can see code. No, it's just... It's interesting actually, what happened. Something with... I don't know. Should be all right now. Wait, why does it have equal 3 and not 5? Wait, why is it different? Understand. Last unique value, so at some point they start to repeat. Hmm. Maybe I didn't hear it yet. Let's print actually count our fives. And they say they need like 11,000, right? Okay. It's like a thousand guys, let's wait for it, I guess then. Can optimize something in here, like print. Okay, print is okay, I guess. It should be alright. Okay, let's see. You say just let it run. Let's see it run. So like it's 1,000 and we need like 10,000. Okay. Okay. So I just lucked. I just lack patience, I guess. Yeah, let it run. It's away.
Just let it run. Just let it run. Let it run. Let it flow.
Almost halfway through. We could probably analyze it somehow, like, but I'm not sure how. We can remove this. We can. It's not much, so actually. Meanwhile, we can probably make solution out of it, right? try to rewrite it. So what we need is this, maybe count plus. We don't need max steps, right? We ignore this actually part of We're close. Equals 28 of index contains R5. We return R5, right? And else we technically, this should give a solution. And part one would be kind of the same. Okay, but yeah, we get to repeat. Okay. This is our answer, right? That's the right answer. Yeah, you just had to be like really, really patient. And how many instructions we executed? It's about 3 billion, right? Yeah, 3 billion. And here, when I tried, yeah, probably had less. But anyways, so part one would be kind of the same. Basically program take 29 program, so we just drop the last exit. If 5, we don't care about this, right? Don't care about this and this. How? I don't remember how remote require works. I just, yeah, there is no namespace. Okay. Okay, let's see if we can run what one. Yeah, seems what we were having, right? Okay, so yeah, let's clear this. Let's close this. We don't have sample nowhere. Right. Don't need this. Okay, so this is kind of what it does. Okay. Seems to work fine. Priority map it didn't as well. That was not easy. 2019 year 2018 day 21. Hopefully no more interpreters in the future. Did I commit it? Yes. Okay, that's it. Thanks for joining. See you next time.